Reuters News headlines 30th November 2021 International News, attack on Ukraine would be costly. NATO warns Moscow. Russia would pay a high price for any new military aggression against Ukraine. NATO and the United States warned on Tuesday, as the Western military alliance met to discuss Moscow's intentions for massing troops on the border of the former Soviet Republic. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken is expected to brief his 29 NATO counterparts on Washington's intelligence. Tens of thousands march against military rule in Sudan, met with tear gas. Chinese President Xi Jinping has pledged a further 1 billion COVID-19 vaccines to help Africa achieve the goal of getting 60% of the continent's population vaccinated. Reports Reuters. More than 100 former Afghan security forces have been killed by the Taliban or have disappeared since the militants seized control, according to a new report by Human Rights Watch. India-born Parag Agrawal, who has been named the chief executive officer of Twitter, is making headlines in India of his birth as many celebrate his appointment. The 37-year-old succeeded Twitter co-founder Jack Dorsey. Twitter has more than 30 million users in India. A graduate of the prestigious Indian Institute of Technology, IIT, Mumbai, Mr. Agrawal has a PhD in computer science from Stanford University. The new Twitter CEO will get an annual salary of $1 million plus other bonuses, that is, 7.50 crore rupees per annum or 62.5 lakhs per month or 2 lakhs per day salary. Reports BBC. Bangladesh removed from the list of at-risk countries for arrivals in India for Omicron COVID variant. Chinese President Xi Jinping on Monday said China would encourage its companies to invest no less than $10 billion in Africa over the next 3 years. Reports DD News. National News, India's gross domestic product, GDP, grows 8.4% in second quarter of financial year 2021 to 2022. Reports Times of India. Chief Economic Advisor K. V. Subramanian today said India is expected to log double-digit growth in the current financial year. Reports Economic Times. India had issued fresh guidelines for international arrivals. According to the new guidelines, all international passengers have to fill up a self-declaration form and upload a negative RT-PCR report. Skill India launches program to upskill street food vendors, making them eligible for e-cart license. Both houses of parliament adjourned till tomorrow. Union Health Secretary Rajesh Bhushan chaired a high-level meeting with states UTs to review COVID-19 public health response measures and preparedness. Reports DD News. Nearly 10 crore unorganized sector workers registered on eSharam portal. India to have 500 million 5G subscriptions. Average traffic per smartphone to touch 50 gigabytes per month by 2027 end, Ericsson. Reports Financial Express. Blood groups A, B and Rh plus more disposed to COVID-19, shows Ganga Ram Hospital study. Reports Indian Express. My only condition for an alliance with the BJP was the resolution of the farmers' agitation, former Chief Minister of Punjab Amrinder Singh said about his new party's alliance with the BJP. Children in India should be vaccinated with the Covavax coronavirus vaccine and not Covishield, Serum Institute CEO Adar Poonawalla told today. Will be ready in 6 months. Reports NDTV. Current COVID vaccines may be less effective against Omicron variant, predicts Stephen Bansal, chief executive at Moderna. Reports New Indian Express. Tamil Nadu News, the Supreme Court has allowed the setting up of a medical board comprising of doctors from the All India Institute of Medical Sciences to assist the Justice A. Arumugaswamy Commission of Inquiry to gather facts on the death of former Tamil Nadu Chief Minister J. Jayalalitha. Reports New Indian Express. Technology News, citing debris risk, NASA delays spacewalk to fix space station antenna. Reports Reuters. Weather News, according to India Meteorological Department, Ministry of Earth Sciences, Government of India, wet spell accompanied with isolated thunderstorms and lightning over Gujarat, North Maharashtra and Northwest and adjoining Central India during 1 to 3 December. Likely emergence of a low pressure area over Andaman Sea during next 12 hours and its intensification into a cyclonic storm over Central Bay of Bengal around 3 December 2021. Thank you. Please subscribe free to iIntelligence, iNews to get more videos on important news. Also, like and share if you find our videos really updating, useful and informative.